that's where I'm getting at. And I just thought about the fucking shit. That's what I'm saying, where I'm just like, men ain't meant to be monogamous. They out here doing what they do. They don't know why. They just doing the shit. It's in them. That's how they're built. Once women accept that, I ain't saying be out here disrespecting your woman, doing all this, 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 and that.
Right now, ladies, I'm about to do a huge favor for you, and that's being honest and cut through the chase and the BS, because most men are going to lie to you, right? I'm going to tell you the truth. Truth's gonna make you mad, but it'll make you free, right? The fact of the matter is this. A lot of women, they say, yo, how many wives you have, Tyler Duck? I tell them I got 700 wives and 300 concubines. They say, nah, I want my own man. I say, well, why is that? You're gonna be stuck with the average dude. The average man does not articulate the type of wealth that I've actually had over the past 7 years. And when a man actually gets to the status, he's not going to settle for just one woman. That's unrealistic. And you women that really believe that, you're delusional. But I'm going to tell you something. Even an average dude, this is what I got to tell you, right? Even a regular old dude is, let's say he's a janitor. That man's still going to have more women. He's going to have more than just one woman. It's just not in the nature of a man to be with just one vajayjay for the remainder of his life. So if you tell your man to, hey, you gotta be with just one woman for the remainder of your life, and you're convincing him to say that, he's lying. Now I know what you're thinking. Not my man. Yeah, your man too. Your man too. The dudes right now be like, damn, Tyler Dodd, you're screwing up for all of us. Now I'm just being honest, man, to put these chicks in the right mindset, because that's what it really is. There is no man out there that's going to be with just you. And so you're really off your rocker when you're thinking that a high value man, a man of status, a man that's making over 200, 300K annually, is going to be with just you. What in the hell do you think you're really bringing to the table that he's going to need from you, that he's going to just settle and be with you? What makes you think that you're that special? I'm really baffled by this. So help me out. Really, help me out, ladies, in the comments. You'll say it's not about money. Listen, man, let me tell you something, man. One thing's for certain and two things for sure. If you don't have money in this setup, then you're losing. You're a loser. So just save the BS and keep it real. What do you think it is that you have that's so special that you're going to offer this man of high status that you haven't already offered someone else? And if he's short like me, he's gonna be like, nah, man, I'm good. So you either, a lot of you women, you could be happy, and you know how you could be happy? You could be happy by accepting the fact that all men are polygamous, unless you breaking this weak ass down like a shotgun, and you got him as square as a graham cracker. Go ahead and tell the doctor when you said it. This is Tyler Dockman. Shalom. Peace. Two fingers.
Y'all remember that baby boy scene? And everybody that's seen Baby Boy, so everybody should know what scene I'm talking about. Where they go to the fast food restaurant and she find the condoms in the back of the seat. So they get back to the spot and he was like, you want me to tell you the truth? He was like, I love you. I care about you. You got my heart or whatever. You got my kid. You probably gonna be my wife. He was like, but I fuck bitches from time to time. I don't know why. I just do. He was like, I lie to you because I care about your feelings. He was like, I'm out here telling these hood rats the truth because I don't give a fuck about them. Blah, 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 blah. That's where I'm getting at. And I just thought about the fucking shit. That's what I'm saying, where I'm just like, men ain't meant to be monogamous. They out here doing what they do. They don't know why. They just doing the shit. It's in them. That's how they're built. Once women accept that, I ain't saying be out here disrespecting your woman, doing all this, 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 and that.
Shalom, peace. Two fingers. Hashtag Tyler Doctrine. I think that the vast majority of women, not all women, should be able to sue the educational system for indoctrinating their minds with the false narrative, and should be able to, so as should effeminate men that has not necessarily acting girly or flamboyant, but the men that has a feminist mindset, you along with many women should be able to sue the educational system for indoctrinating your minds with a false narrative that a man of status, a high value man, and not just a high value man, the typical average man that's masculine, he doesn't have to be high value. If he's in his masculinity, it is unrealistic. Listen to me, ladies. It is unrealistic for you to get your man to say, I do. Then he's swearing to be with only just you for the remainder of his life. That is a lie. He knows it's a lie. And deep down inside, you know that it's a lie as well. So let's just stop the buffoonery and let's be more realistic. The fact of the matter is, there's a deluge of single women out there, right? And many of these women are single because they say, I would rather be alone than to be with a man that already has another woman. But realistically, ladies, you're outnumbering us. So the man's going to, in order for every woman to be able to get that pina colada, you understand what I'm talking about? He's going to have to go out there. And so instead of most men having the respect and being honorable men like myself and admitting it and telling a woman from the inception of the relationship, I'm not going to be with just you. I'm entitled to more than just you. I've established myself. I'm entitled to more than just you. Do not attempt to place restrictions on me. If you don't like that, then there's the door, because there's always someone else that's willing to do which you won't. Men need to adapt this mindset, and then we could fix the society. That could be the end to the single womanhood and so on and so forth. You want to fix it? This is a resolution, and it's in our nature. When you try to be with just one woman, you're warming against your nature. This is Tazadoction. Khan Tazadok, so you know, said it. Shalom. Peace.